Good morning. We start today underneath the Trans-Canada Highway in the neighbourhood of Glenwood. And this is the walk I did around it. Oh, I'm about to step out here. It's probably going to be extremely windy and extremely cold. But the last couple of weeks, it's been below minus 20. So I'm hoping that that means the river is frozen solid and we can take a walk along it. Well, it appears to be suitably solid enough for someone like me. See how far I can get. Louis Riel was the founding father of Manitoba. He was a little bit of a troublemaker, a little bit of a revolutionary, and a bit of a low bridge. And because of all his shenanigans, the government got fed up and said, go take a big plot of land and stop you messing around. Well, he got a nice big plot of land in Canada and he called that Manitoba. Our buddy, Louis Riel, he was quiet for a while, seemed content with the whole of Manitoba, but he was still a troublemaker, still a revolutionary, causing loads and loads of grief for the government. They were probably rolling their eyes thinking, whoops, we just gave this bloke the whole of Manitoba. So they just said, you know what, let's execute him. When he heard about his death sentence, he wanted to get out of here, wanted to make his escape. So he thought he would go to the relative safety of America. It's quite a long way, it's 60 miles south of Winnipeg, so he had to find a way to get down there pronto. This is where our story brings us to one Joseph Abraham Gouin. Now, he was a buddy of Louis Riel. He was a supporter of his renegade ways. And he was a livery man and ran some stables. So he had access to horses. And he donated a horse to Louis Riel so that he could escape to America. I know little to nothing about horses, but I assume that you can't gallop a horse for 60 miles. So let's say a trot slash canter hybrid of about 12 miles an hour, he would have made it to the States in about 5 hours. ever considerate, our buddy Riel says. Oi, Gwei, once I get to Emerson at the border, how am I supposed to get the horse back to you? And Gwei says, oh, just point him north, pat him on his rump, and he'll make his way back. And Joseph Abraham Gwei got this avenue named after him, thus immortalized. And at the end of this avenue is Gwei Park. Very well, let's go and get some warm refreshments here. I hear there's a place that has a cafe inside a bike shop, so let's give that a shot. To conclude this story, the horse did make its way back. It took 3 days. Nobody knows what it did in those 3 days, but I'm sure it was legendary. The horse's name was Tufon, and it means he who carries the storm on his back. It's a Métis French word. Well, unfortunately for Tufon, he was captured for aiding and abetting a known revolutionary. So he was rendered down into glue. And that glue was used to bond a golden boy on top of the legislative government buildings here in Winnipeg. And the horse was called Tufon. That is why the little plinth on which the golden boy stands is called Tufontiere. Just had to do a little bit of grocery shopping there. A few things. There we go, that wraps it up. Well, thank you, Glenwood. I particularly enjoyed your bicycle shop cafe thing. Thank you greatly for your hospitality.